Direct from Southern California, the car capital of the world, the Auto Channel presents exclusive press pass coverage of the Los Angeles Auto Show.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the President and CEO of Volkswagen Group of America, Michael Horn.
I think the applause, we have to practice a little bit, but anyhow. So, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Volkswagen. And of course, before we discuss the exciting new products here and we look at the future, I wanted to update you on where we are in the regard of the TDI and the diesel emissions issue. Volkswagen, we continue to work very hard on approved remedies for the 2-liter four-cylinder TDI engines affected by the September 18th, and you know, it's exactly 2 months ago, Environmental Protection Agency and California Air Resources Board's notices. Furthermore, also, we have now to address the recent issues related to the 3-liter, 6-cylinder TDI engines that will be discussed and clarified with the engines as well. As the CEO of Volkswagen Group of America, I can tell you nothing is more important to me personally than the satisfaction of our customers and to making things right with all those who have put their faith and trust in Volkswagen over the years. I understand and I appreciate the impact that these recent revelations have had on our customers, our dealers, and the US public at large. And there's frustration, and there's sometimes anger, but also support from lots of our Volkswagen customers. And all these reactions are fully understandable, since also everybody at Volkswagen of America lives exactly through the same emotions. My primary task is to push that things are made right, and I can assure you that all we've been working tirelessly towards that singular goal. We're working closely with EPA and CARB, we've been cooperating fully with the regulators, and we will continue to do so in the most transparent and open way possible. And we, and I'm personally hopeful that we will be able to announce something soon about the remedies that we have identified and which we are discussing with the agencies in the upcoming days. So this continues to be an immediate priority. We are keeping our dealers and customers informed about the latest development via a microsite, www.vwdieselinfo.com, where they can find the latest updates on this issue. We've also included a VIN lookup tool so consumers can find out whether their car is affected and even in which generation and which bucket their cars are. We've apologized and we can't stop apologizing because it continues and we need a remedy to our customers, our dealers, and the American people. But we've understand and clearly understand that apologies are not enough. So I would like to communicate another action which we have started as a first step in doing what we can to make things right with our customers and to thank them for their patience through this difficult time while we work on a long-term solution. And beginning of November, on November 9th, Volkswagen of America began to providing owners of the 2-liter TDI vehicles affected by the emissions issues the opportunity to receive three things: a $500 prepaid Visa loyalty card, a $500 dealership card, and a no-charge 24-hour roadside assistance for 3 years. And many of our customers are worried about their vehicles, and we are committed to do what's necessary. And this is just a step, another step, in the process while we work on the remedies that satisfy our customers and the government. Until this morning, more than 120,000 customers have signed up in the web, and this is roughly 25%. And so next to showing our gratitude, this program also provides us with the opportunity to collect all customer addresses in order to have a 100% remedy completion possible. So let me be very clear to you, we will take care of our customers, but this will take time. And this responsibility is one that I don't take lightly. Making this right is the number one priority for everybody in our company right now. And on a personal note also, I've been humbled by many, many emails and letters I've received from customers throughout the US and around the country with their support. And they've stood beside us during really difficult and hard times in our company's history, and I will never tire of saying thank you very much. to them for their continued understanding, patience, and so forth. So this support motivates me, and I can assure you it will be repaid with a continued dedication to making things right for our loyal customers here in the US. They deserve nothing less. Volkswagen remains fully committed to this market. So that was a TDI story. Now we move to the future and to the real stuff now. We are actively working with our dealers, and October was a good month for them, by the way. The dealer business was 20% up, and on a year-on-year basis, the overall dealer business was up versus last year. That's very positive. Also positive, the Golf family continues very strong. We started the year with Motor Trend Car of the Year, with North American Car of the Year, and today, you know, really excited that despite of all these issues that we are facing, the Golf TSI, the Golf GTI, and also the Golf R have been included in the Car and Driver 10 Best of 2016. Thank you very much, Car and Driver. Ladies and gentlemen, I now would like to reinforce that the US market clearly is vital in the global strategy of Volkswagen around the world. Volkswagen has reaffirmed its commitment to expanding the Chattanooga facility, where we plan to produce the newly developed midsize SUV for the US market. As previously announced, we will be investing $900 million in there to produce a newly developed, newly designed 7-passenger, awesome midsize SUV. And I would also like to add that Volkswagen is a mobility company committed to using every form of powertrain solution to satisfy the forthcoming worldwide greenhouse gas emissions regulations. We've already shown that our MQB platform, and specifically last year here, which will underpin most of these vehicles on sale in the US in the future, was designed from the start to include all possible powertrains. So plug-in hybrid, gasoline, also diesel engines, CNG, mild hybrid, fuel battery, electric, and even fuel cells, as we've shown last year here on the show in Los Angeles. In the US, we have committed to sell a full battery electric Golf, the e-Golf. We are selling it for the first 9 months here. We are satisfied with the sales regarding the pricing. And now even better, we've moved the price point down to make it more available to a level of $199 leasing a month, or roughly $29,000 purchase price. So actually, if you're interested, we have a couple of e-Golf standing outside here at the convention center. You can sign up in the booth today, tomorrow, can test drive those cars. So in the case anyone thinks that an electric future doesn't compete in the current world of high horsepower vehicles, you can look there on the right of the stage. And there we have our Golf GTE Sport concept in white, very cool. This dramatic carbon fiber body sports car uses a sophisticated plug-in hybrid drive system that has a total system horsepower combined of 400 horses, which gives you 0 to 60 in roughly 4 seconds. Top track speed, 174 miles per hour. But the car is not just about performance. It has a powerful lithium-ion battery, which does 31 miles per gallon, or 31 miles per gallon in fully electric mode. Ladies and gentlemen, the Golf GTE Sport shows that the future of mobility is just as exciting as it has ever been. So now I would like to move to a car that is tremendously important to us in the US, a midsize sedan that is designed for the American lifestyle, built at our state-of-the-art plant in Chattanooga, Tennessee. And this is the new 2016 midsize sedan, our Passat. Facelifted here, you see the R-Line, by the way. The Passat is safer, more luxurious, more fuel efficient, and offers much more value than before. Striking new front, rear styling, as well as heavily revised interior that has a more premium feel. And I'm excited to say that for the first time here, which you see on stage, the Passat R-Line styling is available, also at very attractive price points. What really excites us, though, is that the new Passat gets a full range of driver's assistance systems and class-leading infotainment and connectivity systems. Depending on trim level, the Passat models come equipped with a host of advanced driver assistance systems. So this is advanced cruise control, forward collision warning and autonomous emergency braking, blind spot monitor with rear traffic alert, lane departure warning, active blind spot monitor with corrective steering. Lots, long list here, and parking steering assist, and also standard on the Passat is the automatic automatic post-collision braking system. Very important for your safety if you had a crash. So we are hopeful that the combination of these advanced systems and the great engineering work will help the Passat to achieve top safety ratings as the previous model did. The 2016 Passat features Volkswagen's second generation modular infotainment system, which we call internally MIB2, so that's not about the movie. The system features touchscreens as standard equipment on all models, and the MIB2 system also serves as the foundation of Volkswagen CarNet system, one of the most comprehensive offerings of connected vehicles and features available in the automotive industry today. The Volkswagen App Connect technologies allows integration with three major smartphone platforms, so Apple CarPlay, Android Auto, and MirrorLink. And this allows seamless integration, and I've checked all three out, you can believe me, it's really cool and awesome. So this is the most and competitive, the most sophisticated and competitive Passat we've ever been produced, built for this market, and we are really excited about it. And so across the range, we've added content on every car, and the cool thing is we haven't moved pricing, so we've just added content and styling and design. On average, the car moved up, has additional content on like $1,250, and if you see the standard model, the S, it's $1,315 additional content without any surcharge for the customer. And for instance, also rear view camera is now standard with all Passats. So we'll continue this right price, right content also for the future. Guiding principle for us and our US strategy. And now I'm also able, because you know our communication went a little bit dark in the last couple of weeks for good purposes, but we are going online again over and on top of our year-end sales event. We have a very cool Passat campaign lined up with three spots, and I would like to share the first spot with you, which is around mid-sized cars are for families, spending that time with your kids, simply the best time of your life, most of the instances. I have two sons, sometimes it's strange, but anyhow. And you know in principle that you never get your time back, which you have missed your kids. So we've developed a campaign for the Passat, which shows how this beautiful designed car with thoughtful, innovative features helps you celebrate the best time of your life. Obviously showcasing all of the new sheet metal and redesigned elements, but also showing the new MIB infotainment system and specifically the smartphone integration technology App Connect, but also our driver's assistance system like forward collision warning. And today I would like to show you one spot, otherwise you just have to listen to me, this is too boring, and which we have upcoming. The spot is called Beth, and it's a 60-second story which shows a father and his two sons enjoying a fun day together. And some of you may recognize the track called Beth, performed by rock band Kiss.
Beth, I hear you calling, but I can't come home right now. Me and the boys are playing, and we just can't find the sound. Just a few more hours and I'll be right home to you. I think I hear the calling. Oh Beth, what can I do? Beth, what can I do?
Text Beth, what can I do?
Message, pick up milk.
Oh, right, milk.
Introducing the newly redesigned Passat from Volkswagen.
What can I do?
Thank you. I think you agree that the tonality is warm, it's optimistic, it's family-oriented, it's fun, and this is, from my point of view, what the brand Volkswagen should stand for. And now, I'm pleased to share with you some exciting news about our involvement in the Global Rallycross Series. First of all, last year we entered the Global Rallycross Championship with two European Polos, with a plan to replacing them with Beetles by the end of the year. Our drivers, Scott Speed and Tanner Faust, did great last year, finishing third and ninth in the title race, and also the Beetles did great, not the Polos in the first part so much. This year, Tanner and Scott started the season with the Beatles, after a mixed first half of the season, wound up at the Las Vegas season final as the only two drivers who could win the title.
Today, we're here in Las Vegas at the season finale. Started off the season really well in Fort Lauderdale, and then we showed up at Daytona, and the wheels kind of fell off. Kept grinding, and we just started rattling off top twos. When the season's all said and done, and Volkswagen is champion, we'll look back at that time and be most proud of that, because that's where the team really battled back to where we are now. This is the first year that we've had the Beetle, and to do what we've done already is a true testament to everybody at Volkswagen and Andretti.
Ladies and gentlemen, Scott Speed. So I thought before you have to look at my ugly face all the time, you can at least look at a young, decent guy. Scott, congratulations. That's awesome. But why don't you tell us what made this success possible? What's the formula for this big win?
Well, thank you so much. Well, as you know, the first thing you need is a strong foundation. And what better foundation than the Volkswagen Beetle? It has proved to be an amazing car for Tanner and I, and you know, without that, for sure, this is not possible. I think the most important thing for us, though, is teamwork. Rallycross is very much a real aggressive sport with lots of highs and lows, and it's an entire team coming together through a whole year to persevere through the tough times and to really continue a fight for an entire championship that ended up leading to us being able to take home everything at the end.
That's awesome. And you know, I think you should take some of our engineers in your team so that we can have quicker remedies for the TDI issue. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
And here we have Tanner as well. Thank you, Tanner. So, since we've introduced the Beetle, we have said that we will keep the third generation of our icon fresh by introducing special models and new trim variants. As a proof point, we are showing two special versions of the Beetle here today, both of which go on sale in 2016. First is the Beetle convertible denim here, which we've previewed this year at the New York Auto Show. Due to go on sale early next year, the denim is based off the 1.8 TSI automatic model. And this, as you know, and some media agencies already have commented on this, is drawn on the heritage of the Beetle jeans bug from the 70s. And it takes its interior and exterior design cues from denim, the blue top, seating surfaces, and even the contrast stitching inside. So also this model will have a great value proposition. And after we've introduced the Beetle Classic this year, which is going to be a similar price point, by the way, sales of the Beetle have really picked up dramatically. So now, ladies and gentlemen, let's look at something exciting to hit the street next year. And this is the new Beetle Dune. I remember my first motor show was in Detroit 2014, and we showed this car as a concept car, as a prototype, and I had a bad bronchitis. That's what I also remember. But I'm really happy that we bring this car now and that we've kept most of the styling and design elements. So it's inspired from the classic Baja Bucks of the 60s and the 70s, of course. The Dune has an off-road look, raised ground clearance, new front and rear bumpers, wider track and black side moldings. And I think you agree it looks pretty cool, and especially in the unique color, which we call Sandstorm Orange. And also the interior picks up on the exterior color and is really nice and awesome, as I would say. Like the denim, it's based off the 1.8 liter TSI model, both in coupe and convertible versions available later to go on sale next summer. So we'll announce pricing at some point of time, but we'll also have a very interesting price-value relationship. Ladies and gentlemen, Volkswagen is committed to this market. Volkswagen is committed to making it right. And Volkswagen is committed to continuously introducing great new products that will excite our customers, our dealers, and hopefully you. Thank you very much.
Thanks for watching The Auto Channel. For more great coverage of all major motor events, visit theautochannel.com, the internet's most complete and comprehensive automotive resource.